What's going on, everyone? It's Bray with Jacoji Fine Jewelry, your personal jeweler, and we're currently at 648 subscribers on our quest to 1,000. Let's go. Abdul wants to know if I recommend wearing jewelry while sleeping. Let's get started. Don't forget to follow me on Instagram at Jacoji Fine Jewelry. Visit my website www.jacoji.com. And don't forget to smash that like button. Smash, 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 smash. Now, I really like this question. You guys do a great job with leaving good questions and comments. Always feel free to reach out to me on here, or you could Instagram me or email me. Sometimes my DMs and emails get a little backed up. It takes me a while to answer, but do know I'm trying to respond to everybody. I get busy, but I really do want to get back to you guys. My door is always open for comments, questions, or if you just want to show me your chain, anything like that. This is what this channel is for. This is what I'm here for. To wear your jewelry while you're sleeping is a convenience thing. You wake up, your jewelry's already on, you don't have to worry about it. A lot of times when I take pieces off, you know, I tend to forget to put them on right away, and then all of a sudden I'm out the door and I'm not even wearing my jewelry. I never ever take the white gold concave curve off just because it always stays. I don't have a problem with this, it's just a part of me. Now with pendants, rings, other things, it's a different story. I do not like to wear my pendants while I'm sleeping. I don't like to wear rings. I take everything off besides this. Let me show you why. This is my main reason. See the clasp, bail on the cross? This does not go over the clasp, so it gets caught. And that's kind of a problem with a lot of things. And this is a short chain, if you guys look. It's a short chain, but it still wraps around me if I'm laying down. And I don't like that because I toss and turn at night. You might be like me. Toss and turn a lot, and sometimes I just worry about this getting caught, and especially right here, if it gets snagged and my arm is under me, I go to toss and turn and jerk and break off. You know, if it's in my bed, it's okay. I can repair it very quickly, but if I'm at a hotel or something and never notice it, it'll stay behind. Maybe it rolls on the ground or something like that. It's very annoying, and I worry about it all the time because I try to adjust and adapt to wearing my pendants while I sleep just because I wake up and they're on me. I want to wear my jewelry all the time because it's gold. It won't tarnish, things like that. So it's important to me. But just having that thought of it snapping and breaking, it keeps me up all night when I toss and turn. It's not worth it. Even if your bail goes over your clasps, unlike this chain does, I don't like it because it'll wrap around. You'll end up, you know, laying on your pendant, whether it be diamond, gold, or on the side, things like that. It's just not worth it. Just look at me now. I'm adjusting my chain because it's a natural habit. We all do it. So at night, I just don't want to do that and have to worry about my pendants. My white gold, it just stays the same. It doesn't wake me. I'm used to it. Pendants, I can't get comfortable for that reason. Is there a huge risk as far as breaking or damaging your chains? Not really, unless you have a bunch of them on and they hit when you toss and turn or something like that. But there's not a huge risk of breaking it, damaging, but it, to me, it's not worth the risk at all. Just take your chains off, your jewelry. Same thing with the rings. You know, they could very well slip off at night. Bracelet, you know, that's one of those things. I like my bracelets loose. Do I worry about them too much? No, but I still take everything off and just leave my white gold one on because it's not worth just worrying about it all night. If you want to wear your jewelry while sleeping, I recommend smaller pieces and shorter chains just to reduce that risk. Obviously, with the longer chains, there's more risk, and I'll make a different video about longer chains and the possible risk wearing them. That's pretty much it for today's video, and we will see you on our next jewelry video.